how many of them were sent to the mail versus delivered by courier.
So I'm not going to get into specifically where we think the packages came from. Some were obviously delivered or in the postal system. I'll leave it at that. Other than that, I'm not going to get into a description of where we think the packages originated. I would reiterate, regardless of where people think they originated, if you see something suspicious or you think you may know information, please provide that to us at those two tip lines.
So in terms of tracking, we have over 600,000 postal employees out there right now, so we have their eyes and ears looking for these packages. I will say, in the postal network, we have found nothing in the last 8 hours. So what we have so far is what we have, 10 parcels.
As to the devices located in New York, which contained a powder, the initial analysis indicates that the powder in those particular envelopes did not present a biological threat.
Were these devices rigged to explode, or were they, do you think they were more sent to intimidate?
So we're not going to, as Bill said, we're not going to give you 100% accurate description of what the devices were, but we have to treat them as live devices. This is a protocol that our bomb squad people use, and it keeps everybody safe.
This begins in the very early hours of the morning when a retired NYPD Intelligence Bureau detective who was awake and watching the news saw the image of the packaging that has been common to most of these devices as they have turned up at various locations. And it struck him that that looked very much like a package he had seen on Tuesday in mail he was to screen for Robert De Niro Productions at their offices on Greenwich Street. He contacted, based on his experience, he knew how to call the bomb squad directly. He spoke to the bomb squad. They advised him to also notify the first precinct, and they went directly to the scene. They were met by emergency service, who with the first precinct were able to locate, based on the security director's instructions, the package where he described it. The bomb squad was then able to use their expertise and equipment to safely package that intact, remove it safely from the building, and then place it in the total containment vessel, which is our bomb transport vehicle, and bring it to the Rodman's Neck range, where it joined the other devices that we got from CNN and from the FBI and Westchester County authorities. By late this afternoon, all of those devices should have been transported by the FBI to the FBI lab in Quantico to be examined by their explosives people so that all the evidence from all of these incidents are in one place.